Morning, everybody. So, I left the flipping clicker on overnight, so it's better than it's not. So, I might have to finagle the video where I can probably hear me a little better. But I'm going to talk a little louder. Maybe that'll help. What we're doing today in our sawmill is we're cutting wedges, wood wedges. I said in my previous video, we help out mobile home movers and stuff like that. We also help out anybody that levels the structure, including these shed movers, you know, the Amish building, already pre-built buildings or whatever. I know a couple guys that do that. So we're trying to help them out today. He didn't really tell me how many wedges he wants, but we're just going to cut what we can cut, and he's going to come pick them up to evening here. What we cutting? We're cutting red sweet gum. Sweet gum's twisted log. I mean, it's just got twisted grain and all that. So, I mean, I use it for beans and stuff. That's what my sawmill bed's sitting on, is sweet gum beans. Sitting on top of concrete blocks, quick grate it in. It's about time to change stuff out. When I go to widening the shelter, that's what I'm going to do. But that's what we're making today. We're making just old wedge is all. It ain't got to be perfect. About an inch on one end, down about 8 inches long, 4 inches wide. I took the liberty of breaking down the log without recording it, because, you know, it's kind of simple. You square the log up and split it. You know, I got an 8x8 out of it, and I just took and split it in half. Got 2 4x8s, and then I took measuring tape, marked 8 inches, took the chainsaw, and cut it up into blocks is all. So, I just cut them up into blocks. I mean, it ain't rocket science, but anyways, this is how I do it. This is a jig I made. I made it out of just scrap lumber laying around here. I had a buddy of mine call me and want to know what the trailer place, want to know if I could help him out. So I figured it out, you know. So I mean, it's pretty simple. I mean, it's got screws in it, and that's what holds the blocks down. It's pretty standard. I mean, it ain't nothing special. It ain't nothing pretty. But let me close these legs up. Maybe I can. So it just sits in twin on top of 2 bunks. You got your log dog there. You lock it down. I got me a spacer board where it's a little easier to maneuver. And you just take this end right here. That end always sits on the bunk. This end right here raises up. So I'm about to raise this end up. Y'all see what I'm talking about. And that's how you're going to make your first cut and get your first wedge. You take that blade and put it right there on the point of the block. And then when it runs out, it runs it right out about an inch. And then you raise it up and just keep on with the process. You can kind of cut 6 blocks at one time. So I'll get 6 wedges out of this run before I have to take the jig and drop the jig back down to the place it's sitting right now. And then I'll just make one fell swoop, come across, and get 6 wedges. Y'all will see what I'm talking about. Y'all hang out with me a minute, and we'll see if we can get us some wedges made. I started cutting this morning and said, well, I probably ought to record a little bit there, and maybe they can see if I can get a little closer. Somebody can get them an idea how to do something, maybe improve upon what I've done got going on. So. Y'all hang tight. Let's see if we can get going. Flip this thing around. Hopefully this battery won't die. Give him die. that quick. I know there's quicker ways to do it, more efficient ways to do it, but that right here works for us. We don't get a whole lot of wedge orders, but when we do, we can probably knock out 100 to 200 of them in, I don't know, about an hour and 15, 20 minutes, something like that, with this little machine right here, this little jig right here. But anyways, that's kind of how we do it, and figure we make a little quick video right quick and let everybody know how we do it. So we appreciate y'all tuning in.